the blood within your veins become inflamed as it gushes and rushes with each outburst of adrenaline that occurs whenever you see the significant other. Each time the symbol of love enters your sight, there is an inhalation of fresh breath that seems to lift your mind to an unparalleled echelon of emotional utopia. There is no doubt in your mind that this is kismet. You were simply meant to be. She sees you, you see her, and your heart pounds vehemently at an almost uncontrollable rate like you never experienced before. So undoubtedly, this must be love. Surely, without a doubt, you've fallen sick without a cure. Sick in love from a stranger who you adore, but who also remains unnamed. So trying to identify this feeling that appears to be untamed, you label this as love at first sight, but some theorists believe that it's simply infatuation that is sometimes followed behind by a very lethal bite. This awakens the logic and revives the intellectual faculties that were previously crippled and held hostage by your emotional authorities. You have grown sick in love for a nameless friend who you believe to be the one. You pursue with great haste, running towards uncertainty as though it were a race, running towards the finish line, which is still yet to be conquered. Your yearning palpitation dictate that you meet, so you do so without hesitation, and you do all things possible in order to greet. It is therefore with great ardor, while ignoring the internal fight between your emotions and your intellectual insight, that you push those thoughts aside as you unite, although this decision will later lead towards regret. But for now, there is an eventual congregation of hearts, or rather an intense copulation of desires, as your pure and your tainted lusts intertwine into an amalgamated production which ushers in an exclamatory notion of emotional expression. This explosive sensation ultimately compels you to utter those few words that seem to perpetually reside in triune existence. I love you. Your eyes drop to the floor, embarrassingly waiting in apprehensive anticipation for the mutual expression that you have uncovered so transparently and so passionately. So with a feeling of compulsion, the words are returned, but a valuable lesson fails to be learned, because it is in this moment that we say the feeling is mutual. But the missed lesson is that true love can never be coerced. The expression of love loses its potency if its communication needs to be rehearsed. Love is pure, love is naked, and love is sure. True love is untainted, and give it to more than just erotic expressions and romantic allure. But eros exists beyond the boundaries of rules. These boundaries draw another image of love, and a more intense picture is painted. Eros is like wildfire let loose in a field of dreams. As the flames ignite yet another midnight fantasy, burning desires long to make these dreams reality. The flames reach a new height as your hormones invite your mind to a celebration filled with erotic delight. The love you wish to explore is heavily concentrated with the lust you possess for the one you adore. There is an anxious internal cry as the instruments between your thighs begin to remind your libido that your lover is drawing nigh. Oh, how I love thee! Let me count the ways. This you say as your intellectual influence continues to stray. You are now governed by libidinous order. I love you, you say, as your mind continues to pray for self-control in the midst of the heat. The fire continues to burn as your reservations are turned into lascivious elation while your intellect retreats. I love you, you repeat, but the commonality of this expression does nothing to validate the authenticity of your emotional comprehension. Now void of inhibition, you pursue. You pursue as a hunter pursues a prey. Your naked desire has utterly consumed your reservation like the wildfire that still burns within your loins. But what appears even more valuable than gold coins is the price placed on the prize. You pursue the prize, and as the prey grows larger within your eyes, you salivate at its unveiling. The disrobing of the prize you have obtained tantalizes your sensual appetite. Your knees grow weaker amidst the darkness of the night. The shaking of your limbs resemble the trembling of your heart, as there is a pounding of the heart that is fueled by the gushing streams within your veins. While you consume the kill, your passion remains, doing a lustful consummation of flesh, spirit, and mind. This manifestation of lust at this moment begins to feel like a validated crime. This unique moment causes you to be thrust into a realm where there is a halting of time. In this still moment, there is an explosion, a volcanic eruption of your senses, as it appears that for an instant in time, all the stars have been aligned in celebration of your sweet sensual jubilation. The secrets of your physical frailties become voluntarily divulged as you lay within the arms of your partner in crime. The validated crime now loses its legality, as in this moment there is a revival of clarity that floods your mind. The sensual faculties have been satisfied, but the spiritual cries have been denied. You say, "I knew this action was wrong, but I honestly really tried. I tried to control myself, but I failed, and now my heart solidly sings a very sad song." You turn and stare into the eyes of the prize, which you will soon almost certainly learn to despise. Your emotions trickle away while there is now an immediate unction to pray. But instead, you lean over while expressing obvious dismay, and with mind-boggling uncertainty, you sigh and simply say, "I love you." You see, true love is far more than sensuality. True love cannot be covered by mindless sexuality. Without the mind, the body is worthless. Without the spirit, it is under your flesh that you become powerless. The thoughts of sensual pleasures may haunt your memory, but don't trade your spirituality for that which is temporary. Your purpose must remain your focus. In God alone, continue to put your trust. There is a love that can penetrate deeper within you than the eruptions of your libido. There is a romance that exists that is far more intense than the lust that you express with the motions of your hips. There is a peace that gives a celestial release that can free you from the captivity of your sexuality. Agape, heavenly love, blissful love. The love that comes from up above. Agape love.